All right, what's up, guys? So this is a longer video, just trying stuff out. We'll see how this goes. It's going to be a little bit more talking, getting to know me, maybe getting to know you. Probably not a lot getting to know you, if I'm being honest. Mostly going to be about me on this one. But playing Paramount War Croc, that's all I'm going to play for this whole video. I want to be really good with him. I was really excited for him when he came out. He looks really cool. He has a really cool kit. He's a lot of fun. He has definite potential. Problem is, I am not good with him. So I'm trying to get into SS since falling out last season, or whenever it was. I actually took a break from the game for a little bit, coming back now. So I'm getting back into SS. That's the goal of today. I've got 6 treasure chests. So the whole point of this video is, let's just go through all 6 treasure chests. You can go through this grind with me, because that's our favorite part of this game, right? The grind. So come enjoy the grind with me. That's, you know, now that I say it out loud, you're right. That's probably like the dumbest part of this to show you. People usually come to YouTube for the good gameplay, and instead I whiff the fucking skill 1 because I don't know how to use it well on this map. And you're going to learn. You're going to see very quickly. That's just poor map awareness, mini map awareness. But you're going to learn throughout this video that I am really struggling to get the most out of this character on this map. Like, I am not that sneaky runner that zip zaps around. Like, I know some people really like Kizaru or Marco, and they're great, I'm sure, but what makes them good is their skill that get them around the map. Same with Croc, and unfortunately I fucking suck at aiming him. Also, I can't really fight there. You saw me die there. I'm not gonna comment too much on any specifics because there's not a lot of good gameplay in this video. I jumped into Katakuri because I forgot again, just force of habit, jumping into the alternate character. I decided to back up here and charge this treasure chest, just why not. I like Katakuri. I just recently got an 85 and I haven't really been testing him out much. I've just been bringing him as my alternate when I'm showing off either Kuzan or Croc or whatever. But he's good. So we're gonna see him running around here. But yeah, so like I said, I'm trying to get good with Croc. If you guys have any tips for me, let me know, because I say I'm not good. That's gonna become pretty obvious. And as a matter of fact, these first few games are pretty rough. I'm not gonna tell you whether or not I go on a winning streak, losing streak, whether or not to make it to SS. You're gonna have to watch the whole video to find out. I'm sure the suspense is killing all 2 of you. But that's all right. So here we are. We're trying to box, trying to get something pulled off here. And that ends up working out, getting rid of the Rayleigh there. But again, I'm very new to Katakuri. I barely know how he works. All I really know is that he usually ruins my day when I face him, and I'm not good at this. Like, that doesn't really aim, really, I guess. I don't know how that ability works. I should probably read more up on that. Again, I just threw him on my team. I haven't really sat with his skills and read up on them. Friendly reminder, this is not the channel to come to for great gameplay. This is where you're coming for average gameplay, so that we can hopefully all have a place where we can feel safe to suck together and try. And there I go down again. Now, I'm going to be totally upfront with you guys. This video is going to get pretty uncomfortable with how bad I play. And there's nothing I can do about that. It's going to be a long one, but that's okay. So we're right now we're 0-5 with 18 seconds left. I'm sure we can pull this one off. I mean, I am the man with the plan, the crocodile with the nope, just gonna stay right the fuck there. And all right, I guess maybe I'll try and get this one. No, 0-5. But it's fine. It's just the first game. There's nothing wrong with going 0-5 in your first game. So that's that one. Now let's jump into the next one. Oh, we're not getting to the next one. Now we got treasure chest, of course. Well, I do like that the game at least gives you one. I took second. You got to give me credit there. I, the very least, took second. I got some points on the board. Somebody went 0-0. Tomato. I mean, it could have been worse. It looked worse than it is. That's, you know, so that's good news. But don't worry. These upcoming games, there's a lot more to offer. Or I'm just saying that to get you to stick around, because let's be honest, I'm not about to get really good with Croc on this next game here. But we're gonna keep trying, and we're gonna see if we can pull this off. I'm dedicated to not only playing Croc throughout this, but trying to use him well. Normally I play very conservatively. I'm not a real risky player, and that's really honestly how I made it into the ranks that I do, is because normally, especially when I'm not filming stuff, I do play very conservatively, and I'll go for those 3-2 wins any day of the week, and that really does go a long way in kind of dealing with both the skill gap between me and a lot of more experienced players, as well as just the character gap. I just don't have the character box that a lot of people have. I have barely any characters at 100. My Croc, you see, is only level 80, which is viable in the hands of a decent player. If you're good enough to get into SS, a level 80 character should theoretically be good enough to be competitive. It just depends. And boom, I nail that skill one, jump over there, grab the treasure. Now, did it really give us a major advantage? Not really. That law is right behind me, but we see that the Mihawk takes care of that. I'll throw him a good job. And of course, he's paying attention because he throws a thanks right back. Love to see that. So I'm going to sit here and charge this up a little bit. But they're coming for me. That law is coming for me. But of course, he's going to drop that skill too. Or is it skill one? I don't know. I was just about to be like, of course I know how to deal with this. Law is my main. I know, but I honestly don't even know which one's skill one or skill two. I just use them. You know what I mean? I don't even pay attention. Like, if I was looking at it, I'd know. But honestly, I could not, if you paid me, I could not tell you which one's which, even though he's literally my best character. But I knew he was going to engage with it. I knew how to time it. That's why I was able to dodge it. And luckily, I was able to catch this Shanks here. He tries to get away, and he's maybe, but I ended up smacking him. And you see that Mihawk's a little bit upset. He's a little bit upset. And also, fun fact, do not disturb mode does not apply to Dragon Ball Legends. I guess they're like, fuck you. You're playing a Bandai game. We're going to allow ourselves into your gameplay. So we die just in time for the team boost so we can really, you know, let that go to waste. So you might say, Tyler, just jump in to Katakuri and don't lose this for your team. Don't be that kind of person. But you know what? You know what? There's no crime for losing when you're trying your best. So now losing because you're playing like a shithead is a bit different, and that's frustrating. But you know what? Sometimes you want to showcase a bad character or a character you're bad with, or you just want to try and get good with somebody. And you know what? I'm not going to not play League Battle just because I'm not good with Crocodile. So this is how you get good. You force yourself into these difficult situations and find out very quickly that Croc is not a particularly effective unit against a Shanks. You might think he is, given the color advantage, but in the hands of somebody like me who can barely wield him at all, he's honestly no match for most characters, let alone a fucking Shanks. But we're going to hop over here, and I'm debating what I'm trying to do before I decide. I should probably just come over here and try and help. But unfortunately, what I end up doing is dropping a tornado right as he throws his count. Guys. Okay. So this is as painful for me to play as it is for you to watch. I understand that. You're like, why are we signing up to watch these 0-5 losses? And you know what? Because I suffered through them. I suffered through them so that we can get you this cutting edge gameplay of what it looks like to struggle and try and strive in this game where communication barely exists. That's honestly one of the reasons why. Okay, so I went last 2-0, which, to be fair, someone went 0-0 and got more points. So I'm not gonna act like I really. I think we all tied for last on that one. But back to what I was saying. No, that's kind of the reason why I'm trying to get into the YouTube stuff. Is, you know, there's communication sucks in this game, but I think there's a really strong community potential underneath it all. And so I'm hoping that even shitty or mediocre players like me can jump into the YouTube sphere and start getting, you know, just getting more engagement and getting more people involved and sharing tips and tricks and their own videos, whether you become like an actual YouTuber streamer or you're just like putting up your own gameplay clips. That's all good stuff. We're all trying to figure out how to play these characters, and there's no real way to do it in the game. Obviously, there's Discord servers and things like that. People are getting together, but that's all starting from YouTube. So that's why we're here. So this game's going to keep throwing us onto Arlong Park, which is fine. I actually like Arlong Park. It's one of my more preferred maps. I know it's got one of those gimmicks. It's not like a damaging gimmick, but it does have a gimmick with the doors opening, things like that. Maybe people don't like that, but I've always thought that the balance on this map, regardless of which version you get, has always been pretty nice. And I enjoy that. And the fact that you have to pay attention to what's going on behind you. And God damn it! Okay. So sometimes I'm just going to run over here and pretend like that didn't happen. I'm just going to run around this way and pretend like, you know what? I'm still going to get this flag here. You know what, guys? Flags are overrated. Maybe I'll just drop this and stun the Blackbeard, but doesn't. So he dodges and he gets me with his skill. Who gives a shit? All right, so So we're starting off real strong. This game's going well. Is based if you saw how the last two games went, you can probably imagine how this one's going to go. But believe it or not, it actually works out a little bit better this time around. Honestly, would I upload 25 minutes of straight losses? Well, the answer is yes. I probably would do that if I thought it was good enough footage or funny enough footage. But this isn't. This is me just more experimenting with long form and trying to get a sense of both commentary as well as discussion. I don't know. If you can YouTube better, then you fucking do it. Then we can all do it, and it'll be great because that's how it's supposed to be. And naturally, getting taken down by Blackbeard. Who would imagine a red EX given a green level 80 a little bit of trouble? That's predictable. But that's fine. It's only halfway through the match. Doors ain't even open yet. We only just went down a treasure, and we have a little bit of team boost. I'm going to pop over here and actually land that where I wanted to. And that Luffy, I don't know if he's like, was that a bot? Like, that was, it probably wasn't. But, like, he ran by me like bots when they just, like, they're like, yep, I'm the bot. I guess it's my job to go get through treasure now and not even interpret the fact that somebody here is about to steal this one. Like, they just, you know, you guys know, you guys have played Challenge Battle where after the first, like, 12 hours, nobody fucking plays. So you're just on teams of bots every time. That's what that Luffy was. But that's okay. It's going to give me a chance to get a couple treasures in here and maybe redeem myself a little bit as being just an absolute shithead teammate for the last couple games. Now, obviously, these are different teammates, but you know we're pulling off some good stuff here. And that Fujitora, thank God, is there to protect me from the Shanks, who I have obviously learned my lesson with at this point. So he's going to charge that up. I'm going to charge this up. We're going to keep an eye on this Shanks. And things are not going to look good for the Fujitora, but that's okay because I'm going to jump in here and do absolutely nothing while his meteor does all the work. But that's fine because, like I said, it's about winning. It's a team game. No one's here for the glory. Well, some people are here for the glory. I'm not here for the glory. I'm just here just because I want to, you know, play cool characters and do fun stuff. And the more I win, the more I can do that. So I always go for the win. 3-2. That's perfect. Let's get this law out of here. And look at that. Look at that. We're only three games in and we're already getting a win. So 2-0-5s. But now we got a 3-2. Give a great to the MVP. I like to throw greats whenever I can. At the very least to the MVP. It's an easy reminder. I took last, but again, did okay. Yeah, 3,000. Got two captures. You guys remember those probably both very vividly. They were right there in the middle. Very deliberate, and then that's really all I did that entire game to help the team, but that's two captures we didn't have otherwise, so I'm going to roll into another one here. I don't remember how this game turns out. I remember how some of these games turn out, but these next couple are a little fuzzy. No, well, maybe not. I know how they end. I just don't know actually what happens, so that's exciting. That's one of the nice things about doing a video like this is I'm not wasting too many ideas on these prior to because I'm watching them almost fresh because I really have no idea what to expect. I always throw a Watcher 6 out there. It's a good reminder to, you know, mini-map awareness is really important. Traditionally, when I say Watcher 6, it's usually a loss. But I don't believe in superstition, so fuck that shit. I'm going to say Watcher 6 because it's good advice, and I'm going to nail that skill there. I see I'm getting better, guys. I'm learning. Like the robots, I'm learning, I'm getting better at what I do, and eventually I will be able to take over. And I'm going to sit here and box with this Lucci, and I don't know how that was going to turn out, but based on how the rest of this fight goes, I probably owe my life to that Shanks, because look at how quickly that Lucci evened these odds. But, and then what happens here? We both, that's two, ready, and a third. Three times we cancel each other's basics out on each other, but it was just enough to get the kill, and we'll just sit here and charge up the treasure. I know that's not a runner's job, especially a runner who has mobility like Croc, but damn it, guys, I'm just trying not to lose at this point, trying to be a little bit effective, but I see a meat. I'm hungry. Now there's a Marco. God damn it, and luckily I'm able to pop my skill off, get away from him, get the meat. Let him do what he wants to do. He's going to go over there, and I'm just going to throw a guard treasure and hope that my team does such, but he's going to run away. So I'm just going to run in here and take this one behind him. And here's the thing. He's just going to go take that fine. I'm not going to go fight him. He's going to get it before I can. Then I'm on his turf, and that's not going to help anybody. So we'll just sit here and charge this up and just kind of wait for him to come over here. But now that I got the team boost, I'm like, nah, fuck it. Let's go get this guy. I anticipated that, just didn't time the dodge right, but I was able to get an advantage there, throw up a tornado, throw down a tornado, and watch as he literally just runs headlong into it like he doesn't know any better, which I guess, I don't know, if you're not from the Midwest, maybe you don't know how tornadoes work. I remember when I was in boot camp, we had a tornado siren go off, like there was a tornado warning, and they made us all hide in the bathroom, and we were talking, and I made jokes or something. I don't know. We were just, you know, bullshitting. And we were laughing, and one guy got really pissed, and he's like, "Hey, man, be quiet." And I was like, "Yeah, guys, keep it down. The tornado's going to hear you." And boy, he looked at me really angry. And then I was like, "What? Is this your first tornado or something?" And he's like, "Yeah." And that's where I remembered that the Navy's full of people from all over the country. And some people aren't used to that. Because, see, when I heard the sirens go off, I was like, "Fuck it, brick building. I'm going back to bed." But I guess people were a little bit spooked by that. But I'm not afraid of no tornadoes. That's where I'm from. That's what I know. And that's why Paramount War Crocodile is my guy. That's not true, actually, at all. It has nothing to do with why I like him. It's just a pure coincidence that he has, you know, tornado powers. And it's more desert-themed than anything else. But I like the desert. Arizona, specifically, is a cool place. Been there a couple times. Wouldn't mind showing up there in the future. So now that Marco is coming after me again, I think he's just upset because he's like, "I want to be the better runner." But I didn't quite catch him in my tornado like I had hoped. So I let it go early just so I could smack him, because otherwise he was going to come out of his stage. And I do nothing here again while my team secures a victory. So there's the good news, is that we got another win. That's two in a row. Clearly no thanks to myself. I'm sure at this point the Cooks Alliance is really regretting just this willy-nilly allowance of this little symbol there, whatever you want to call it. I looked it up. Apparently, it's like a Japanese hot spring symbol. It's so I went 3-1, almost 5K points. So I didn't really do that bad. The whole team did well. I just, you know, contributed the least. But no, the hot steamy bowl of soup there, symbol of the Cooks, is actually for hot springs, I guess. Accidentally flicked my phone off of silent. And then realized that my phone's been on silent this whole time, so I flipped it back on silent for consistency's sake, but I could have swore that iPhone recorded in-game audio even if the phone was on silent on, like, the outside. Like, I thought that's what was on the inside that counted, but that's not what happened here. So instead, if you haven't noticed, there's no audio on these, so hopefully my voice hasn't been too terrible. You're not getting any other gameplay audio, which is a real bummer for such a long video. I should have figured that out beforehand before going into this, but I told you, we're going on a journey, man. We're going for SS, and that's just what we're going to do, and I angled that terribly, but it's enough to get me where I want to be, and I'm just going to zip-zap, zippity-bap, right past that tornado, and that Snake Man is clearly just not going to pay attention. This is a great example, guys, of why minimap awareness is so important, because even a punk-ass player like myself can get an advantage on players who are probably much more skilled than me, or at the very least have the character advantage, but instead they just did what they always do rather than being situational about how they play. Don't be fooled. My skill with a particular character is not necessarily the equivalent of my knowledge of what I should be doing with that character. That sentence didn't make any sense. But I guess what I'm trying to say here is, even though I'm not good enough to defeat this Mihawk, I'm good enough to not die while holding here at this treasure. As you see, we get a 5-0. So that's really what I'm getting at, is you don't come to me for the gameplay to watch. You come to me for just pointing out all the shit that you shouldn't do from my gameplay, really. It's kind of the opposite. I'm more of like, here's what to not do, and if I do something cool, then maybe we can enjoy it together. But that's really all that we have to offer. But I take second in that case. And let's be honest, that win was definitely a big part of what I contributed. So I feel good about that one. Got into SS. You thought I couldn't do it going 0-5 in the first two games. You were like, no fucking chance in hell, this guy. But there, and yeah, sure, I got carried a little bit, but at the end of the day, especially those last couple games, I did fairly decently. Getting a little bit better with Croc. I haven't used him in a while. I was a lot better with him when he first came out, when I was doing the challenge missions, the challenge battle on Thriller Bark. I was a lot better with him then, but I think that might have also just been because people were a lot less familiar with the character, so didn't know how to counter him as well. Whereas now, He's a little bit easier to navigate around, but he can still do some damage, especially in, again, back to challenge battle. In order to do the brawl or the melee, whatever that one is, where it's just KO counts, and the more kills you get, the higher your points go. He can be pretty good in that one, because it's just such a clusterfuck of people mobbing each other. You just drop into the middle of that mosh pit and throw your tornado down, and people don't really know what to do. Yeah, maybe they escape, but then your teammates just, you know, jump all over them, so... He can be good in a lot of different modes, including in League. This is just not a great example of that. So, predictably, I'm going to do the exact same thing I did before. Nailed the skill that time, aimed it a little bit better. And again, we're going to through there. Got hit a little bit. But this time, a Snake Dat Man does pay attention. A Snake Dat Man, I can't even say his fucking name. But the point is, he fucked me up, and this Lucci's not helping matters. So... Yeah, I mean, I'm not going to lie. Even before I did this, I'm like, how much you want to bet this is going to go the complete opposite the second time around? And that's exactly what happened. And then yet again, in my panic because of how terribly things went and this being my last treasure chance, I dropped into Katakuri, not thinking. I'm going to go for the law. He's going to run right past me because he's not an idiot. But I'm going to get the perfect dodge and get him away from my treasure a little bit while this Snake Man comes over, and I'm gonna just beat up on him. Tried to knock him into the tornado, didn't work. He's gonna throw down his little rumble ground arena or something. I don't know, it's got a name, I'm sure. But and now he's running away, which is a good call when it's 3v1, but he's still gonna punch the Marco. Like, I mean, that's honestly just rude. Like, who turns around and just punch? Like, that's like the guy who just punched Rick Moranis the other day. Like, just walking down the street and said, fuck you, don't shrunk the kids, or whatever his reasons were. I imagine he was upset about him shrinking the kids. It couldn't have been for the Ghostbusters. That was an amazing film. But that's what that Snake Man is. Snake Man is now a stranger punching Rick Moranis. But we're going to get that middle treasure thanks to the Marco. We're going to get out of here, try and avoid those tornadoes, and we're going to... drop our skill to there to try and get some heal and get him off our treasure, which didn't really succeed in the heal, but we got him off our treasure. Marco took care of it, and it's 2-3. We got a minute left. That's okay. We're back into Croc, which means, you know, it's pretty much a done deal. We're gonna lose. Maybe if I was still playing Katakuri, we might have had a chance. He's got more survivability as a character. I don't know how to play between the two. He's got more survivability, and that's ultimately what it comes down to. But we're gonna do our best. We're gonna dip, dive, and dodge, and all that good stuff. We're gonna throw down our tornadoes. We're gonna try and yank people around. Who doesn't want a hand job from a hook hand? I mean, other than literally everybody who's ever thought of the idea, including people who haven't thought of that idea. I imagine you wouldn't have to be asked if you want a hand job from a hook hand for you to know instinctively that that's not something you want in your life. But I've seen a lot of weird shit, so don't let me kink shame you. But we're gonna bring Croc back in. I don't know, he's got sort of a, there's something about him with that dark trench coat and he's got secrets, you know what I mean? And they're not, like the deep, dark, dastardly kind, just kind of you know what I mean? The kind of secrets that make you go, oh, like he's got those. I feel like, it's this Paramount War Croc particularly. There's something about the dark look, because he went from the bright look to the dark look. It's just such an emo move that you can't help but feel like he's got something going on in his life that makes him feel like people just don't get it. But I do like this Croc. I'm going to keep trying to play him, even though I had as many terrible games as I did good games on this one. But I made it to SS. We made it through. If you watched all the way to this, holy shit, I don't know why, but I appreciate it. So thanks for that. And I guess, I don't know, I guess I'll see you guys in the next one. I'll figure out a sign out next time, and maybe not on like a black screen. But yeah, see you guys later. Well, or you'll hear me. I won't see you. That's weird. The sign out has been landed successfully. I can't imagine how it could get worse by continuing on as opposed to just ending this right now.